Hi, my name's Mick Rouse. I'm head of photography for Angling Times. I'm also an absolutely mad keen pike angler. Today I'm going to run through the best and safest way to unhook a pike. First things first, let's have a look at the tools we're going to need for the job. Well, first and foremost are a good set of forceps. I prefer the ones that have got the bend in the end, simply because you get a lot more leverage from them. When you've got the forceps in the pike's mouth, you need to lever the hooks out of hard bone, skin or whatever, and that's the best thing to do. Secondly, a spare set. I always carry a spare set of forceps with me. These are the straight nose variety, as you can see. I carry them because it's very easy to drop them in the water, it's very easy to lose them, misplace them, and you've always got another set to hand. If for those stubborn hooks, when you get a hook really embedded in a pike's jaw and you need a bit more leverage, then a pair of long nose pliers are absolutely essential. You can get in there, get the hooks out nice and neatly and quickly, which is most important, and just for that extra leverage, a pair of long nose pliers. If you're in real trouble, then it is absolutely essential to carry a set of these. They're sort of bolt croppers or hook cutters, as we call them, and they're designed to simply chop off the bends of the hook. If the hook is embedded or in a particularly difficult place, far better to lose a hook than to lose a fish. So chop out the hook, unhook it as quickly as possible. See a lot of these on sale. I'm not a great lover of these. These are too long. The temptation is to ram it right down the fish's throat. You get virtually no leverage from it. So I would stick to some of the shorter versions where you can get the twist and the leverage on them. If you need to go any further down the fish's throat, then the best way is to very, very carefully go through the gills. So they're my first top four that I would use every time. Okay, first things first, we have our pike safely on the unhooking mat. Absolutely essential to have an unhooking mat with you. Doesn't matter about leaving the net where it is, it's perfectly safe, nice soft cushion for the pike to be on. As you can see, I've just straddled the pike so that its main bulk of its body is between my legs. The reason for this is if it kicks, you've got somewhere to stop it gaining leverage on the ground. Then all you need to do, as I've just done, is to lift the gill flap, and you can feel there are no teeth, no nothing. Gently slide it up until you feel the jawbone of the pike, lift its head, take your tools, and as you can see straight away, one hook is just perfectly in the mouth, twist and lift, and as luck would have it, the second set of hooks is already released. If the other hooks are in, always take the one nearest to the end of the mouth first, unhook that, lift it clear, and then go for the second set. But that was much of an easier job than I thought, so let's get him back in the water. I think you'll find nice fish of about 12-13 pounds, Excellent. And it's as easy as that. Just remember, have your unhooking mat ready, have your tools ready, firm but fair with the fish. I personally don't use a glove. Sure, you're going to get the odd grazes, the odd nicks, but if you do my way of doing it, then you won't come to any harm, and even more importantly, neither will the fish. Enjoy your piking.